Now, I'm going to speak for as little time as possible, but I do have a few announcements I have to get through first. First off, we do request that you, if you have a cell phone, please turn it off, as well as anything else that might make any noise. Secondly, if you have food, please do not eat it in the auditorium. There will be an intermission after the sophomores play. Please feel free to eat food in the lobby then. Also, if you are interested, we have 3 raffles going on outside. Tickets are $1 for 1 ticket, and that would be 3 for 5. I mean, double check that. Related to the raffles, we would like to say a huge thank you to Bedford Farms, Bedford Spa and Polish, and Chippin Farm for donating things for our raffles. And now, without any further ado, please enjoy the Freshmen's Carmen Plays.
A series of what we are henceforth referring to as high emergencies. At pans or pie plates or pie forks. The bakery was neat and tidy just as I had left it the night before. All of the tables and chairs were accounted for, and there was no money missing from the register. But all of my pies, my delicious pies, were gone. Then, at 7:42, we received a call from Rosa Patterson.
My trophies! I have won Pretty Briar's annual savory pie baking competition 6 years in a row, and I have 6 savory pie trophies on my mantle. Each one is a bronze slice of pie, perfectly mounted on white marble, and they are arranged so that when guests come in, the first thing they see is my trophy collection. When I woke up this morning to get the newspaper, I realized that all 6 trophies were missing. I looked everywhere. I woke up the kids. I thought that they were playing some kind of trick on me. I looked under the couch, in the yard, the pool, the shed, the fridge, the doghouse. Nothing else appeared to be taken, but my trophies were not returned now. So naturally, I called her.
And then at 8:14, we heard from Principal Mason. It's the darndest thing. When I drove up to the school in the morning, I take a left on the shady pasture road and into the high school driveway. And I only see the American and the BRIAR flag waving at me. So I know I didn't see the gun. Of course, the BRIAR flag is bright yellow. But this morning, when I drew in, the flag was missing. And call me superstitious, but I knew something was wrong.
And then the number of telephone calls just got overwhelming.
Pie cookbooks are missing from the library. Pie memorabilia and souvenirs have completely disappeared. Pie mural at Daisy Lane has been painted over. This is by far the most bizarre case I've seen here in my 17 years as mayor of Pretty Briar. Ladies and gentlemen, I hate to say it, but it seems that everything pie-related, all of Pretty Briar, has just vanished.
What should we do? What can we do?
It's hopeless.
There must be an explanation.
I've never seen anything like this in my entire life.
What do we tell the kids?
We can't tell the kids.
We don't want to scare them.
Okay, you're right. Yeah, good point.
Wait, until when?
We'll find out.
All day.
Everything is gone. Everything is changed.
Who would do such a thing?
How to do it?
They left no trace, slick as a snake. This is clearly the work of an experienced individual, a madman,
or woman.
This is the work of a villain. This is the work of some cold and cold.
No, no. This is not the work of someone. How would one person successfully steal every piece of pie product from all of the Pretty Briar? It must have been a group effort.
You're right, there must have been a collective. Maybe it was a club.
Maybe this was some kind of initiation.
Hazing.
Hazing?
In Pretty Briar? Never.
Not in the history of Pretty Briar. Everybody's has to be like this.
What are we supposed to do? Go off on our days like nothing happened?
We can find out who did this and bring them to justice.
Yes, make them pay.
Take them to court.
Throw them in jail.
At least force them to give everything back to the rent holder.
What if they destroyed everything?
I don't even want to think about that possibility.
But it's possible, right? I mean, what if they have done all this whole time?
Who do you think did it?
What do you think?
Well, isn't it obvious? Who is the one person in all of Pretty Briar who doesn't have anything nice to say about anyone on any day of any week? Who shuns this town's pie fry? Who never buys pie or bakes it? Who doesn't participate in any of our many pie competitions? Or pie meetings, pie parties, pie festivals? Who doesn't have a pie bumper sticker for their car? Who doesn't dress up as their favorite kind of pie for Halloween? Of course.
You're right.
You're so right.
Old Man Boris.
Boris Fenwick, also known as Old Man Boris, is the oldest, grouchiest man in all of Pretty Briar. He rarely leaves his garage where he clears his building for his spaceship. A spaceship, but a bunch of full rolling. Boris Fenwick has made his disdain for pie quite public. Years ago, it's a bit of a crude story.
He pissed all over the pie.
It was It was rather bizarre. It was the 2009 quarter annual cobbler contest, and Old Man Boris shows up and just urinates all over the pie's foot. Then he randomly laughed at me. Strange behavior. Very strange behavior.
Old Man Boris is spaceship. I think he's insane.
I think he needs to be medicated.
Of course you would do this. Of course you would.
We don't want to commit the great pie robbery.
He's got a motive. He's got a history.
I'm convinced Old Man Boris did it.
Jumping to conclusions and evading fear. This culprit was a bravely in the face of crime. Let's remember the foundation of compassion, community, and trust that Pretty Briar was founded upon. Go home to your family. Stop by the grocery store on your way home, and by God, get into your kitchen and bake the pie!
Mom? Sweetheart? Didn't you go to school?
We can't go to school.
Oh, that's understandable, I suppose, in light of what's going on. I need to get to the sheriff's office and debrief. Why don't you pick up some flour from the grocery store and I'll meet you back at the house? I'm trying to get Tom back into the pie spirit.
Okay.
Come to the pie room, I promise.
Okay.
Hey, Mom?
Yeah?
Never mind.
Do you really think old man Morris did it?
Do I know you?
Diana, I just moved here today.
Today? Why, you're the pony that you moved to Pretty Briar.
Oh, believe me, it wasn't my decision. My mom got a job at the bakery.
Which bakery?
Is she more than one bakery in a town this size?
There are six bakeries, and they each specialize in different kinds of pie.
Wow. In that case, I have no idea which one my mom works at. What's your name?
Lemon.
That's a lemon meringue pie.
It's my mom's favorite.
This is weird.
It's not usually. Today's just weird. Super, super weird.
Are most people here named every kind of pie?
Well, there's cherry stones today. The sheriff's dog's named rhubarb, but that's about it.
Oh, that's a relief. I want to be the only person here without a fruit for him.
What is your name?
Jack.
So, do you think old man Boris did it?
Probably not.
What makes you say that?
Well, most likely suspects are never the person who actually committed the crime. The real culprit is always hiding in plain sight and acting like they're just as scared and upset as everyone else. Nobody knows it's them until it's too late.
So who do you think of all the pies?
Maybe your mom did it.
Shut up! My mom would never do something like that!
Sorry.
You should be. My mom would never do something that terrible. She loves Pretty Briar and our pie spirit more than anything.
Pie spirit?
It's like our spirit about pie. It's past fucking energy and enthusiasm.
About pie?
Well, better about pie than you know about guns or cigarettes or animal cruelty or something.
Yeah. What would everyone name their kids then?
I know you don't get it because you just moved here. But you really are lucky to live in a town like this. Everyone is really supportive and friendly.
Yeah, except to old man Boris.
He committed a crime.
By peeing on some pies at a competition, I can think of way worse crimes.
Have you ever committed a crime?
No, I just think that spending all this time on pies seems a bit silly.
It's not silly, it's who we are. It's our livelihood. If you don't like pie, then you moved to the wrong town.
Do you like pie?
What?
Do you like pie?
I live in Pretty Briar, pie top of the world.
That's not an answer.
No one's ever asked me if I actually like pie before. It's sort of assumed if you live here, I guess.
And if you're named after.
You know, I was supposed to read at home in front of my English class today. I get nervous in front of big groups, so I've been practicing all week. I've been standing in front of my mirror home and studying my poem before my homework. I was still nervous, but I was feeling good about reading my poem. No, prepared. I'm actually kind of excited to share with everybody. I want to be ready when I grow up. But then a whole robbery thing happened and school all canceled and I was not going to get to read my poem. I want to find a book that's just a bunch of anybody else, but I...
Sorry.
Can I tell you a secret?
Yeah.
You have to promise not to tell anybody, ever.
I promise.
Pie makes you kind of nauseous. Not really, actually kind of a problem.
Hey, what are you doing right now?
My mom wants everyone to go home and start baking. It's part of her plan to get the umbrella. But the last thing I want to do is make a pie right now.
So let's go.
So where?
Come on.
Thank you. no need for that kind of talk.
You know something? You people are nuts. You think I'm the crazy one? Ha! You should see yourselves getting all worked up over this pie nonsense. I didn't take anything, but whoever did did this town a giant favor. Wake up, smell the coffee, there's more than life than pie.
Hi, Bella. You shouldn't be living in Pretty Briar.
I'm an American citizen. I can live wherever the hell I want to.
Now let's go get Hasty. Forrest has lived here for decades. He's a part of Pretty Briar just like you or me.
He's a thief.
You got no proof.
Mr. Fenwick, can you tell me where you were at 6 a.m. this morning?
In my garage, working on my spaceship.
Do you have any witnesses?
You're welcome to talk to my cat, Pussy Boots.
How about last night?
Same place, doing the same thing. I wake up, I eat breakfast, I work on a spaceship, I read the paper, I work on a spaceship, I feed the cat, I work on a spaceship, I eat lunch, I work on a spaceship, I eat dinner, I work on a spaceship, day in, day out.
That's very dull.
A lot less dough than making pies all day, that's for sure.
Spinkle, I am going to have to ask you to stay out of the investigation.
Yes, show us you like to work for us.
You want to see my spaceship? Fine.
Thank you.
I left my house at 6:30 a.m.
That doesn't seem like a lot of time to steal all the pie and pie-related material and all Pretty Briar. I mean, between the library, the school, the bakery...
I worked quickly.
Did you have any help?
No.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
No help. No help at all.
No.
You do understand that this is a crime, son. That you could be put in jail?
Yeah.
And that doesn't make you upset?
No.
He's covering for someone there. He has to be.
Ladies, this is a private interrogation.
Then why are you doing it in the town square?
Well, you see, we've never really had to interrogate anyone before, so we really don't have a designated.
This is ridiculous. My flour, my rolling pins, my baking sheets, they're all still missing, and until they're recovered, how am I supposed to bake pie? How am I supposed to operate my business?
How am I supposed to get up in the morning knowing that my trophies won't be there for me?
And how about my cookbooks? What am I supposed to do when people come to the library and ask for the history of the blueberry? What am I supposed to tell them?
You want answers, Jack?
Mayor, can't you, you know, wrap him up or something? Desperate times call for desperate measures.
You can't physically harm me, it's illegal.
Violence has never come to Pretty Briar.
Well, there's a first time for everything.
Everybody, please, just calm down. Let's just all take a breath.
Just kill the beast! Don't kill him, but do something.
Matter. What matters is what we do now, today.
Alaska.
No, that reminds me of Fake Alaska.
What if we discover a whole new planet?
Of course. Why didn't he ever want a spaceship before?
Wasn't the right time.
It's kind of like you're waiting for us.
Someone had to put those kooks in their place.
What do you think of all the pies anyway? It does seem like too big of a job for one person.
I have no idea. But whoever did it to that town of giant fader, they learned a valuable lesson today.
Yeah, I mean, maybe whoever took the pies is actually a good guy in all of this?
Maybe it was my dad. Like his spirit or ghost or something?
Maybe.
I'm worried about my mom.
Don't be. We'll be fine.
Do you think we'll ever come back to BRIAR?
Yeah.
Ain't it beautiful out here?
Hey, Lemon. Do you have that poem with you?
What?
The poem that you were supposed to recite for your English class.
Oh, yes, it's right here.
Read it to us.
I'd like to jump from star to star, dancing the evening air, collecting all the night's secrets. On this evening, the sky winks at me. It has heard my wish and prepares for my arrival. The comet whispers, follow me, wait till I see it, wait till I see it. And suddenly I'm riding, as if on horseback, galloping through the galaxies, riding on Saturn's rings, bouncing on a moose trampoline, collecting the stars in my pockets as I fly. The comet says, welcome home. I smile on my back. It's a new world.
Really hard to fit that spaceship We're ready to go on. I just say that.
Yeah. And up last, what did you guys learn from doing the show?
I knew that a lot went into creating a show for theater, but now that I have had the experience of being a leadership position crew, I realized that the leaders of stage crew have a lot more on the plate than probably most of us know. And I'm just really glad that I got to be in this position for a few weeks.
Group really did a good job. Yay! Stars are out.
Excuse me? That was me, Chris.
All right, thank you, Sarah and Will. Alright, so before I hand you over to the sophomores, I do have one quick announcement about their show. In the show, they are going to be using two fake gun props, and there are going to be gunshot noises. That is part of the show. People are very excited about it. With that out of the way, however, I'm going to turn you over to the sophomores. So here is the sophomores' entry for the tournament plays.
Let me get this straight. The police don't catch me when I assault a man. if they catch me for pickpocketing, I mean, seriously, like, I totally didn't do
that. I'm Jack, and, I was convicted of stealing a lot of pie stuff.
No, they had no idea you're crazy. He's supposed to say like a guy. He was convicted of attempted murder.
Today is Friday, May 8th. Please rise and wait for guards to escort you to the mess hall.
Hey, Paul, get up. George, can you help me out here?
Take the bananas.
any other options?
I don't know, but it has to happen today. So whatever it is, we have to decide now.
Wait, today? It's too late. The new inmates already came yesterday.
What? What are you talking about?
Well, we tried yesterday, didn't we? And we didn't even get to the part where we could even use the bananas because we got caught.
Huh? That never happened.
Anyway, I've already made the deal, so we can get the goods away now.
What? I told you 1,000 times that the only way this will work is if we're always on the same page. The new inmates come today, which means it's probably the only time that a plan could ever realistically work. The warden will be busy giving the new inmates a tour, so this is the one time that she will actually be out of her office. So we can get the key, which means we'll be able to escape.
Oh my god!
We know.
We've been through this so many times. Cope.
What are you making him do?
We got bananas out the ass.
You got a bunch of bananas in your pants? Are you just really happy to see me?
Attention, breakfast is now over. Please proceed back to your cells.
It's go time.
Thank you.
escort you to the mess hall.
Hey, you got that?
Yeah.
Wait, what?
I thought you were gonna get it.
Why, you didn't get it?
No.
You were supposed to go get it.
No, it's supposed to be your job.
Well, I don't have
it. Neither do I.
What are we gonna tell?
Shh. Do you guys have it?
Well, I guess it depends on what you exactly mean.
Oh my god, have they given it to either of you?
No.
I asked you guys to do one simple thing, and you can't even... Whatever, I'll deal with you two later. Now let's go get it.
Hey, over here.
What?
Can I borrow that?
No.
Jeez.
Leave the gun, take the banana.
Good morning, Lynchfield. Today is Friday, May 8th. Can you ride? School in Litchfield. Today is Friday, May 8th. Please rise.
Yet.
Dude, I haven't been paying attention to anything since the
banana shortage. Right? Where'd they go? Ghosts? Give me one.
Take the bananas.
will wait for guards to escort you to the mess hall.
Especially since you're doing it to five people.
What are you talking
about? My friends.
No, I just told you this. They actually committed their crime. I checked their files too. Here, look at them.
How could you say that?
I'm serious! You honestly mean that five people from the same group of coincidentally didn't commit their crime?
You're the one that's lying to me, and you just don't want to admit that none of us should be here.
They're obviously lying to me. You just don't want to admit that some people are going back. Not everyone's good, so you're trying to accept that and move on.
You just said I shouldn't be here, even though I actually am. So how can I be certain that I'm also true with my friends?
Why did I lie to you? Especially since I hope it's admitted that you didn't commit your crime, which I'm getting fired by the way!
But none
of that matters if we don't find a way to stop the name from repeating.
Thank you.
After you.
This thing?
And you technically.
Oh, man.
Alright, so first up, how are you guys feeling right now?
So relieved.
Oh my god. Yeah, you guys want to say something?
I'm feeling downright fantastic.
So happy.
So what sort of things that went into the show that think people didn't notice first?
I don't know. What do you think, Lewis? What I think is that people didn't realize how fast we had to react in order to get every scene perfectly synchronized, repetitively. Not get to repeat the same thing over and over. Actually, it was better than doing different scenes.
And we were really intense about making sure they were doing everything.
All right, so how did you guys go about writing the script?
You can start.
Sam also helped write with the two of us, and... The
banana ghost!
Yeah, so we've been writing this a long time. Yeah.
Alright, so out of everything that just happened, what was your favorite part?
My favorite part, which I think we nailed tonight, was the overlapping argument we had between Nate and Izzy. Because that took us so long.
Pass.
I was fond of the mess hall scene because even if you weren't looking at someone, they were doing everything they were doing in every other scene. They were just mouthing the word, but they were doing everything every time.
And now, lastly, what do you think is the most important part of your play?
As you may have noticed, sound.
John Coyne.
Important for all of us to work together because we were almost all in every scene, so we all had to be working together on the same page.
That's it, right?
Yep.
Alright, thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Alright, so if whoever's in the booth wants to put up house lights, we're going to have a brief intermission. If you want to enter any raffles, there will be people out there to help you with that. If you want to buy any food, you can also get that out in the lobby. We do request all food and drinks remain in the lobby if you do not enter the auditorium. Thank you. See you after the break.
You're right to call it off.
Besides, you know, Marissa was great together.
No, Ella, this honestly sounds tacky as hell, but it wasn't you. It was me. I just wasn't ready for college. I was a stupid kid back then, but college has changed me, I swear. God, I miss those days. Just you and me and Mr. Fluffykins the Rat. Where we fell asleep in your backyard and he meant everything to me. And I threw that all away just so I could be with new college girls who were interesting. That didn't even happen. I'm dating my best friend from high school. Ella, please, I never stopped.
And we come bringing food! What's going on here?
Quick pause. You got me into my guilty pleasure. And Ella here apparently loves it too.
Are you serious? I love K-pop! So, when you say you like you watch it, do you mean like when you're bored or when you're sick and have nothing else to do or when your parents are bugging you to do homework?
June, I swear to God!
Mark!
December, look it. I didn't mean to yell.
It's fine.
It's not fine. Mark, shut up. You always do this. If you're mad at me, just tell me. Don't take it out on April, okay? Had enough of this. I'll be back.
There's really an orphan in here. Well, more like a room.
That was awkward.
Look, January, I didn't even know.
Yeah. No, it's okay. We're all a bit warm. Look, do you guys want ice cream? Yeah, ice cream! Look, that place has the best self-serve south of Canada! So, I'm gonna go get some. Do you guys want some?
No.
Yes.
Well, I'm gonna go get some. I'll be right back.
Please. Me and Marissa aren't doing so well, as I'm sure you noticed.
Oh, no, of course not. Girls always get out of the car to get away from their boyfriend.
Ella, please, I just...
dropped out.
speak of the devil?
Hi, Ella.
Hey.
So,
I'm gonna...
You're going 360 degrees, you're not. You're going in circles right now.
Yeah, okay, come on.
a year ago. I know it's Marissa. Get that through your head.
I just thought maybe that you would say something along the lines of, oh, I would never do that to a friend. And like, give me my cue.
That was supposed to be before.
Okay. Alright, wanna get started now? Alright. All right. Now, I'm right. You're wrong.
What?
I'm not important. First, Ella, I'll do anything.
About. I will never date you! You strumpet! You lying traitor! You said to you that there was nothing between you! I just saw you kiss him!
I didn't kiss him! I'll try to stop for harassing me!
Oh, yeah! Of course, that's where you pulled his face into yours!
What? What? I didn't steal your stupid boyfriend! You said yourself that he wants to be with you because he wants to be with me.
You take that back!
What? No!
No!
You said
that!
No!
Really? Children!
You guys, you know who disgusts me?
That Mark!
That Mark! He absolutely disgusts me! Okay? So.
We're all calm. Now we can talk. Listen to me civilly without any complaints, okay? So clear your minds of everything that happened. You don't need to remember all of that, okay? Now, all I know is that Mark came along and ruined your friendship. Because you guys were like best friends. You were always hanging out together, okay? And then he comes along and the jerk that he is, he ruined it all, okay? So what I want to see is I want to see you guys become friends again. Because I know you can, and all we have to do is get rid of
Director, and I wrote the play. So.
Alright, so first things first, how are you feeling right now?
So ridiculously relieved, you have no idea. It went so much better than I ever could have dreamed, ever.
Now, as far as why that's true, I don't want to ruin the surprise. Why don't you tell us about a few of the things that went wrong?
Yeah, so as you may have picked up from our little joke there,
never.
We lost, like, the majority of our cast this past week. And so we had originally had a different show, and this one came in at the very last minute, so we had to drag in, you know, one of our crew members, Mark there. He was originally crew. We were proud of him. So yeah, it was an adventure trying to pull it all together so last minute.
Yeah, when did you guys actually write the script?
So I wrote it Wednesday night.
And now, how many times did you guys rehearse?
We had today practicing here, and lots of run-throughs in, you know, Miss Barnett's room upstairs, and that was pretty much it. Took a little bit of time yesterday too, but not nearly enough.
So how exactly did you go about writing your script?
I went up to one of my friends in the hallway on Wednesday morning. So basically my entire cast is left. We have a 7-person show and like 3 people to do it. How can I write a show? What's an idea? And so they said, you know what? You should write something about a love triangle. And I was like, okay, what's the name of the stationary set? Car. So
that's
sort of the
round.
That was me, by the way.
Yes, thank you very much.
And so was there any sort of overlap between the 7-person script and this one?
Well, we tried to throw in a few jokes here and there that were written there by our own Mr. Poe, who wrote our original script for us, so sorry we couldn't do it today, but thank you very much for it, we loved it.
Thank you, Mr. Poe, you're awesome!
Alright, is there anything that you would like to say to your cast now that all 3 of them are here?
Well, guys, thank you so much for bearing with me and letting me, you know, be ridiculous and write a script, you know, 2 days before the show, and somehow managing to memorize, like, it all in a day. You guys are amazing, and just thank you so much for doing this.
And now, finally, what did you learn from doing the show?
Let's see. I learned that it's really useful if you have some people who are really into theater in your grade and who aren't doing sports. That's really awesome to learn from you. But most of all, I learned hitchhikers. Don't pick them up.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
One more last time for the juniors. All right, and without any further ado, I'm going to turn it over to the seniors. No, with a little bit of further ado, because we're plugging in the piano. Oh boy. All right. But I'm slowly going to walk over to this side of the stage, because that's where I need to be. Huh? Oh god, I'm not doing this. All of my terrible jokes are about PC. Oh god. Oh, this is gonna be terrible. Let's do this.
Okay, so 3 pieces of rope are in a desert. And so they're starving and, you know, really dehydrated. So, you see a McDonald's?
The pieces of rope.
What?
You said 3 pieces of rope?
Yes.
Are really dehydrated?
Yes.
Just wanted to get that
They're
out.
In the desert.
Okay.
So they're starving and dehydrated and they see a McDonald's in the distance. So rope number 1 is like, dude, let's go get some food, right? And he goes to McDonald's, and he's like, can we get some food? And she's like, sorry, we don't serve ropes here, like, it's just like a policy thing, sorry. He comes back to his friends, and he's like, nah, they don't serve ropes here, man. So then the second one is like, nah, let me talk to her. So then he goes in, and he's like, all right, look, we're like starving and stuff, could we just get some like free burgers? She's like, nah, sorry, you don't serve ropes here, like, regardless of their status of starvation or dehydration. So he goes back to his friends, and he's like, nah, it's not gonna happen. So then rope number 3, smart one, he starts doing some yoga. And he just...
The rope does yoga. Okay, we got that.
Lift her up! And then he does up his hair, real fancy. You wanna make a good impression, right, ladies? So, he goes in, all fancied up, limbered up, Let's talk about the undressing room scene. Okay, so he goes in all fancy up and he says, look, my friends and I are starving. Can we dump down 3 burgers and 3 sodas? We'll be out of your hair in no time. She says, are you one of the pieces of rope that's been harassing our store? And he's like, nope, I'm afraid not.
A tremendous thank you to our very own Bo Smith. And now, expert piano technicians, are we good?
Yes.
With the piano? All right, we're good with the piano. So, without any further ado, the senior tournament plays.
George. George.
Sorry. Brenda, I need help.
What?
So, today is Rose's birthday.
Yeah, I know that.
And seeing how you're her best friend,
yeah.
I was kind of hoping you could help me come up with a date idea for tonight.
You didn't remember?
I already did that with Rose.
She's coming over soon, you know.
Oh, God, really?
Yeah, like, any minute now. Thanks.
Well, will you help me out?
There's this cool little dinner theater place by the water. Sort of a cabaret theater thing. It's pretty hard to get a table, but if you make a reservation ahead of time, it should be fine.
Brenda, make a reservation?
Yeah, it's this thing where you pick up your phone and dial this number.
Well, we're thinking it's tonight. I'm thinking I'm not going to be able to get a reservation.
Okay, so you pick up your phone and dial this number. I don't speak much English, but you'll manage. Now, go. What?
Can I ask for another favor?
What?
When Rose gets here, can you remind her we're meeting at Kobe at 3?
Right, because she's the one of you who forgets things. Now go. She'll be here in a minute. Or this minute.
Brenda?
Through the backyard, into the kitchen, living room, and mud room.
Thank
now go!
You. Thank you.
And do not touch anything.
Thank you.
Talk with
me. Sorry.
about?
Well, you ever notice how every story is a love story these days?
Yeah.
I wonder when that happened. It's always about some college-aged idiot trying to get the girl on the end.
And they always win, too.
I don't like that. That's not how the world works. It's not one guy trying to resolve one problem with one girl. There are other people, other problems. Things happen. The world just isn't as simple or as happy as stories make it seem.
Nobody likes a sad story, though.
You know, that's how I know nobody will ever write anything about it. I've never had anything of a love life.
Really?
Yeah.
Huh. Still, though, say that someone were to put you in a play. What would be the purpose of this moment?
Probably to cover for a certain age.
Well, Pat, don't. Well.
Beautiful. You've the soul of a poet.
I just. Well.
Thank God you don't break your own songs.
Pat, there are a lot of seats out there.
Yeah, there are.
Like, a lot of seats.
Yeah.
And you're expecting me to go on that stage and sing for all those seats.
I mean, I'm pretty sure they're less concerned with you singing to the seats than to all the people in them. I was just talking to the manager. Sounds like it's going to be pretty packed tonight.
Oh God, Pat, I can't.
What?
I can't do it. I can't go on it.
Jesse.
There are going to be a million people out there and I'm going to...
Come on, you know that's not true.
There are going to be a billion people out there and I'm going to get on that stage and I'm going to bomb.
You are not. You're going to be fine. You're going to rock them.
I don't sing rock.
You're going to soul them. You're gonna be fine.
I'm gonna be anything but fine.
Jesse.
Look, I'm shaking.
Oh, come on.
Feel my hands.
You're cold.
I'm shaking.
No, you're not.
I am shaking.
Your hands are entirely still.
I'm a white woman earthquake.
I'm texting your boyfriend.
Why?
Because I just can't manage you right now.
Isn't that what I pay you for, to be my manager?
Ain't enough money in the world to make me able to manage you right now.
I'm gonna fire you.
Be my guest. In the meantime, I'm going to be making you get on that stage. Here. Those are the keys to this room. You're ready to go on at 9:30, all right?
I'm not going on.
Your boyfriend should be here soon.
Where are you going?
I'm
going
to go grab a coffee before your show.
So you should be setting up the stage or something? Aren't you my manager?
I thought you just fired me.
Get out of here.
I'm trying, but hey, until your boyfriend shows up, you've got this whole room to yourself. Make yourself at home. Try and calm down some.
So what did the sea say to the beach? Hey, what did the sea
say? I'm not giving you the satisfaction of the answering.
You're no fun. Oh, hey, welcome to
coffee. What did the sea say to the beach?
What?
Nothing. You should pay you.
I guess I were out.
No, it's not.
Are you sure? I would be glad to.
Excuse the old grouch. I'm just trying to have me a little fun.
I'm trying to get a coffee.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. What would you like?
What's the strongest thing you have?
I can make you a dead eye. 3 shots of espresso and a normal coffee.
Sounds perfect.
So, what's up?
What?
I mean, you're basically trying to kill yourself with caffeine. Why?
It's a work thing. Don't worry about it. What are you two guys just arguing about?
Who? Me and the old grouch? You're arguing.
Taylor, here just took a single comedy class.
Workshop.
And is now convinced that she's God's gift to man.
You're drinking. Are you saying I'm not?
I'm saying you do this every month.
What?
Yeah, you always do this, where you take one small arts department class, and then you convince that you're a master. And you always feel the need to show up to me.
That's not true.
Wood carving, pie making, jailbreaking. Remember your ceramics class?
Yeah,
I had to buy all new cups. I swear it's like clockwork with you. Once a month, you're off to class.
I mean, I guess, it's just kind of become a tradition.
Like Passover!
What?
Sorry, it's just, back when I was little, my grandmother, she was very Jewish, and me and my family, we were very not. Anyways, I remember we'd always go to her house for holidays, and I remember we'd have Passover Seders, and we'd always toast next year in Jerusalem. And then I asked my Catholic mother why we did that, and she said, I don't know, it's just kind of a tradition. Like your classes! I'm sorry, that was a lot.
It was, yeah.
I think you've had enough.
And you were thinking I was going to be your worst customer today.
Oh, wow. Sorry, guys. I have to go.
What?
Jesse isn't one of
those. Oh, no, you don't.
What?
We
like we're to lose another person right now?
Another Charlie.
Right.
Riley, I really-
Sit down. Sit down.
Dakota.
What?
Are you seriously sitting right now?
I-
Go.
What?
Go deal with Jesse. I'll cover you here. Seriously, go.
Listen.
Nope, go. Now?
Thank you.
So we can borrow my roommate's camera as long as we agree not to let Mason touch it.
I said I was sorry!
But that still leaves us without a... Where's Dakota?
Had to help Jesse out.
What? He couldn't. I told me...
I told him not to listen to you!
You...
It's only 10% of our grade in an elective class. His girlfriend comes first.
I can't believe you did that.
Wow, we crawled off her ass and died.
She's got her reasons.
Oh, come on, Casey.
No, seriously, she's just trying to stay in school.
What?
Are you deaf?
Or just stupid?
What?
She's on the edge of losing her lacrosse scholarship.
She's on, you know, academic probation, and if she loses the money, she's not going to be able to go to school.
Liar.
What?
There was no way it was. It must be perfect.
Mason, she wasn't sober for, like, any of last semester.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow, I just... How did you...
You're really terrible at this whole listening thing.
What?
She literally starts talking to herself about it every single time she starts pacing.
Really?
Yeah. Maybe she's not actually the problem here.
Wow.
Yeah. I'm here!
Charlie? What took you?
There was a lot of traffic out there.
You don't drive.
And...
Come on, guys. Can we please... Charlie?
Riley?
You're late.
I know.
It's 4.
What was?
Did anybody come up with any ideas while I was gone?
No, Riley, I'm sorry about that. I have one!
Anyone else?
What if our strip is about someone who thought they were a whale? And our entire play is about their fight against the United States Congress to get a legislation passed recognizing this elegant creature of the sea. We are the spirit that has to be the bad guy. Oh, they can only speak in whale puns!
Oh my god.
Speaker of the House, look what we found outside.
Well, 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 what do we have here?
I hate everything.
Dude, get the guy in the march on the Capitol. Make a speech. Ladies and gentlemen, let me
out blow balls.
I hate you specifically.
I say, where there's a whale, there is a way.
Mason's okay.
Was okay.
Ask me about her situation. Riley, she feels the need to be an island. She can't let herself trust us. And so she starts pushing us around being nasty instead. And you know what that makes her?
Human?
A
don't be rude!
Look, I'm not saying she's a bad person. I don't think bad people exist. I'm just saying I refuse to feel bad about not liking someone who can't trust me enough to let me help her. Don't believe me? Watch.
Come on, guys. Can we just get back to work? I really, really need this to be perfect.
Perfect? I think we can do that.
We'll see.
Seriously, never fallen in love before? 76 years old, not one stupid crush?
Well, I guess I had something of a crush. A long time ago, a girl named Emerson.
What happened with her?
Nothing. A whole lot of nothing. She actually still lives nearby, takes care of her mother.
Why do you know that?
Well, maybe it wasn't that long ago.
He's an ass and I don't need him.
Yeah.
All he needed was a couple hours to make up for it. He couldn't even do that.
Yes.
Look how that worked out for us, huh, George?
Mm-hmm. I feel like crap. Yeah. This, today, I feel like crap. Yeah. Happy birthday to me. Hey. What's wrong with you? You were fine earlier.
You know, I just don't like seeing you like this.
Oh. Neither do I. At least I have friends like you looking out for me.
Yeah.
You kept warning me about George. If only I'd listened to you. Should have listened.
Oh, come on. This is just one night. Maybe he just needs a second chance.
You don't get it, Brian. This was his second chance. It's not the first time he's done something like this. Eventually you have to stop giving people second chances.
Yeah. Well, Rose, you're angry now. You'll get over it.
Maybe, maybe not. Not tonight, at least. Tonight, I'm staying angry. And you know what else? I'm gonna make you a promise. From here on out, I'm gonna trust you 100%. I'm gonna listen to you. From here on out.
Yeah.
So, two men walk into a bar, third one ducks. Yikes.
Yeah, I have heard better.
Really?
Yeah.
Prove it.
Fish walks into a bar. Bartender asks, what would you like? Fish croaks, water!
Horse walks into a bar, orders a drink. Bartender asks, why the long face?
Bear walks into a bar, orders a drink and some nuts. Bartender asks, why the big paws?
Bear walks into a bar, orders a drink and some nuts. Bartender asks, why the big paws? Bear says, I don't know, I've always had them.
Bear runs away crying because it's always judged on superficial appearances before the contents of its heart.
I just like to man off into a bra!
A priest, a rabbi, and 300
dozen! We get it!
You're both horrible people! No, 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 please stop!
I could get used to someone like you.
Oh, God.
Do you think it's by another?
Water?
Taylor, right? What else you got?
What?
Hey, Justin, it's me.
I know.
Want to let me in?
Not really.
Okay.
Are you gonna try and force me to go on stage?
Not if you don't want to.
I don't.
Okay.
This is weird.
Yeah.
Yeah.
key to this room, in case, you know, you want to come back.
Maybe this is the reason that everything is lobster for these days.
Yeah, take a sale.
No, really. Think about the basic outline of a love story. A boy meets a girl, they fall in love, he does something stupid to mess it up, then he does something even more stupid to get her back. And in a relationship, people do things like that. You meet someone, you fall in love, you make mistakes, and you do what you can to fix them. You hope it works.
See, that's my problem with love stories. Love doesn't actually work like that. Life isn't that simple.
Yeah, I agree with you. Did you know that ancient Greeks had four different words for love?
Really?
Yeah. Agape for romantic and brotherly love, philia for friendship, eros for, physical stuff, and storge for familial affection.
So why did we decide to turn all of those into one big word?
Maybe we were hoping that if we simplified the language, we could simplify the thing itself.
When that didn't work, we started making movies simplistic for the same reason.
I mean, there's this great Oscar Wilde quote, "Life imitates art." Maybe we're making these simple stories hoping that, at some point, our lives will follow suit.
Yeah, maybe. Or maybe it's ticket sales.
Still though,
I'm sorry, we didn't help you figure anything out.
That's okay. I guess it was a good way to pass the time.
So, do you think you learned anything?
No.
Well, one last try. Whatever that girl's name was. Emerson, right? Call her up. Try speaking to her. It couldn't hurt.
I couldn't.
Oh well. Worth thinking about.
Would you like to do this again tomorrow?
Sure.
I'm hungry! Think!
Right.
No, we can't leave until we at least come up with
how long have we been here?
We've been here for 8 hours. You've been here for 6.
Yeah, sorry. I was avoiding you. But don't you think that if you haven't come up with even a plot in 8 hours, maybe you ought to try something different?
Hey, I've got the plot. You don't get it.
Like the whale.
I really, really just need a second.
I know. And Riley, I want you to know that I'm going to do everything in my power to make sure they ace this project. Because I've heard about your situation. And it sucks. It really does. But believe me, I'd be so much more capable of helping you if I wasn't hungry, tired, and grouchy. And Mason just came up with a perfectly great solution for that first one. I'm leaving, and I'm pretty sure these guys are coming too. Right, guys?
Totally, yeah.
We're going to make this movie, and it's going to be perfect. But Riley?
Yeah?
I'm going to need you to trust me on this one first. Okay.
I'll drive.
Hi, Emerson. This is Alex. Well, I was talking to a friend about you. Well, would you like to meet up sometime? Soon? That sounds great.
Thank you.
Give it up for us.
How's everyone doing?
Great.
Good?
Totally.
Okay.
Yes.
So.
Hello.
Hi. Do you want to introduce yourself? Say what part you had in this production?
My name is Holly Feigl. I was a co-director with this gentleman here, and I also backstage.
And I was part of that. I am Mike Mahoney. I wrote the show.
Talented!
All right, so, Holly, what part of the show would you say that you were happiest with altogether?
I definitely think we really came together in the end because so many people are new to tournament, and a lot of people I've been working with for the past 3 years, so it's really nice to be able to kind of come together and have, like, something solid in the end, I guess.
Yeah. I'm sorry, I was literally just jumping with joy backstage because of that. Alright, so up next, what do you think was the hardest part of the rehearsal process for the group?
I definitely think tech had some issues initially because we had so many different like allocated times, and because we were the oldest, we got the latest time slots, and we were here until like 8-9 o'clock at night. And because of that, some people had conflicts. But I definitely think we kind of made did with what we had.
Made did with what we
had. Thanks. What?
She edited the scripts.
I did.
Okay. Beautiful. Beautiful. All right, so what do you think things in the show that people wouldn't notice would be?
Well, one of the main parts of the show that we kind of had, I have a little demonstration, okay. for the door frames, we're really stressed, like, not completely knocking. It's kind of like, you know, like from the knee, not the hip. We talked about that. But it was kind of, it was more, I guess, actor-based than, like, sound effect-based. Like, the sophomores, bless your soul, had so much tech, and I was like, oh, I'm glad I didn't have to do that.
Yeah, for those of you who think she's joking, we literally spent 3 days arguing about the door thing.
Yeah, we had door conversations, you know.
It was a big deal. It was like, it was, how can we make it so that the play supports something where we can get away with doing that montage thing that we just did at the end?
Oh,
and
God, that was the first time we rehearsed that.
Alright, so what were your goals with this production?
I guess my goals, as cliche as it sounds, was to just have it turn out, like, have a good senior year, I guess. As silly as it sounds, but, I mean, it's kind of nice the way that we've changed it to be in the spring, because now it's like, oh, we know the people we're working with, you know, like, we have it all together, and it's just a good way to end the year.
I'm very much with you. For any of the cast who are in here, thank you so much for your dedication. I was really working the whole senior writers thing. It was going to be a lot bigger issue than it was. You guys are amazing. Okay, maybe minus you, Jared. And now, up last, what do you think was the most important piece of your show?
I know you have a very strong opinion on this, so how about...
My opinion's stupid.
Well, I mean, you wrote it.
Alright. I think the most important piece, and this is going to sound really silly to anyone who just actually watched what the show looked like, but was the Jessie's key moments, whenever she was passing the key along. I just think that that little detail was just what tied the entire thing together and what kept it. Even though the only thing that stayed consistent throughout the entire scenes was May, I think that that just tied the scenes together very tightly. So that's my opinion. Do you have anything?
We had some discussions initially, like during the first week or so, about like the, like, hey, keep this key to my room, like, in case you want to come back, and everyone was like, woo! And yeah, he was like, no, that's not, like, it's not supposed to be.
It's supposed to be a nice thing.
Yeah.
Stop that. Alright.
They know who we're talking about.
Yeah. Alright, thank you, Holly.
Yeah.
Alright, one last time for the seniors. Alright, so this is the part of the night where the judges get kicked out so that they can go judging. They have a very hard task in front of them. First off, however, I would like, or before, while the judges are out, there we go, that's English. I would like to call up the grades so that they can give thanks to any special people, so I'll go with the production. We're going to go in order, so if the freshmen would like to come up. Or I guess the freshmen. I mean, I was thinking for great people come up, but I guess they're not feeling it. I like this.
Alright, we'd like to thank Mr. Poe. Not only, I'd like to thank Mr. Poe because he's the one who basically organized all of this. He helped out a lot, and he really made the scenes look as good as they could. And and thanks to crew.
Also, Mr. Poe, there's only three of us in crew, and so he was the one that helped. He like built most of our stuff and sets for us, so he, without him, we didn't have an interesting spaceship thing.
And Alexa, I don't know. It's actually just an
interesting. Interesting.
Yeah. Yeah.
I recognize you, Alexa. You built the sun.
We definitely need to thank Mr. Poe a ton because, you know, we're just freshmen. We don't just start first year doing something like this. And he basically organizes a lot. And crew, thank you so much. We only like three of you. I don't know too much about what you did, but I know that you. I feel like it's like all this work and you all spent a lot of time after work working things.
I'd like to thank Caitlin, our student director, for and helping us.
Keeping us safe.
And yeah. Keeping us safe, yeah.
And on track, so.
Many notes are very helpful.
Danielle, we love you too. You're great.
I'd like to thank the audience. If we couldn't do this, if we didn't have an audience, well, we could, but it wouldn't be as.
Alright, thank you, freshmen. Would someone like to come up? Maybe possibly not the entire cast? Alright, just going to the entire cast.
Thank you.
Especially me. I'm not sorry. This is great.
So yeah, again, we really want to thank our advisors. You guys helped us so much, bringing us together. Thank you so much, Mr. Poe wrote us a play for 7 characters, and we didn't have 7 actors, so we wrote a new show this week. It's a... and I'm really happy for my fellow cast members. And yeah, we took a pretty minimalistic approach. I think you could tell our set and stuff. Pretty great.
One last thing, we just want to thank Caitlin Emerson, who was in our original cast and couldn't be here with us today due to extenuating circumstances, but she was so dedicated and worked so hard, so thank you, Caitlin.
All right, now we're going to call the seniors. Yeah, look at this, we got a line and everything. So before they all get up here, I just want to do the first thank you. I would like to say a huge thank you to our crew, which is Lauren Bannister and Alexa Vafiades. Just as quick as I can, Lauren was amazing, even not having a huge role in the production up until the very, very end. She was still there and was stage managing and being our line prompter so often. And then Alexa fixed literally every set piece on this stage.
I helped.
Holly helped. But without Alexa, not only would we not have had a set, I doubt we would have had a show. So massive thank you to Alexa. Also, but I would like to say a big thank you as well to Albert and Jay, our lovely tech crew. Again, without whom we would not have been able to do anything close to what we just did.
So our next thank you of the night actually goes to the person who you have been hearing his voice all night. So we want to thank Mike for writing the show and co-directing and really putting us all at our place. You might not have been able to tell, but Mike originally was not going to be acting in the show, and he really stepped up to the plate and like did a really great job, and so we really wouldn't have a show without him, and he kind of wrote it so we wouldn't have a show without him. So we all just want to give a big thank out to Mike. There you go.
Big thanks to Holly, our other co-director and editor. When Mike wasn't putting us in our place, it was Holly. I don't think we would have gotten anything done if she wasn't there. So
I'm the cool director.
So thank you so much, Holly. We owe a lot to you.
Kudos to you guys. Yeah, move along.
Alright, so who would like to help me pick the raffle?
Ryan!
Okay, Jared.
Charlie!
Okay.
I have to say it.
Okay. $10 gift card to Bedford Farms. Get your tickets ready. All right, the number is 8948366.
I won!
One more time. It's 8948366.
They
obviously might have left.
Okay, next one. No, this is Bedford Farms. Bedford Farms, 8948486. This is for the awesome pedicure from Bedford Spa and Polish. 8948342. Oh. And finally, for the fruit basket, that awesome fruit basket, thanks to Mike Mahoney.
Thanks to Chip and Barb.
And Chip and
Barb. Welcome back.
8948501. We have a song from a trio here at the high school are going to perform for us.
Thank you.
We have the winners. So first of all, I'd just like to thank everyone involved in this night. It was a really great night, full of a lot of student original work, and it was really exciting to see it up here on stage. So we have several noteworthy performances to announce before we get to the big prizes. So we're gonna verbally announce those. You're welcome to come up on the stage, and then we will move on to the big trophies. So our first noteworthy performance is for Caitlin Dukes. Our second is for Neil Lusad. Performance is for Christopher Bowers. Next, we have a noteworthy direction award going to Deborah Weidman and Jared Bishop. Performance/whatever awards goes to, well, it's a writing/directing/perseverance in making lemonade out of lemons to Rebecca Kelly Bowden. And now for the trophies. For the best new actress, Christina Solitro. For the best new actor, Nate Heit. Isaac Singer. For the best lead actress, Isabel Hakala. For the best lead actor, Nate Bizette. Okay, for the best ensemble, the juniors. Okay, for the best original script, Mike Mahoney. For the best technical design, the Sophomores. And finally, for the best production, the Seniors. Mr. Poe and I, the two advisors of the Drama Club, would like to thank everyone, and we hope to see you all at our future Drama Club events.